Hello everyone, my name is OopsIDev and today we're going to have a look at signals in Godot 4. Let's get into it. Okay, so imagine you're a video game character that is stuck in a zombie-infested world. You're running through a building and zombies are scratching and hitting at you, trying to bite you. Your weapon is broken and you cannot fight back. Your health is almost fully depleted. You're going to die. Unless you find some antibiotics. How would the game know that you've been bit? Or that you've taken antibiotics so that you can update your health? On the flip side, how would the game know that you've given up and press the menu button to quit the game? You guessed it, signals. Previously, we talked about nodes, which are the main building blocks of your game. Now, these nodes emit signals when some event occurs. In this sense, you can think of signals as triggers which only go off if a certain action has been executed. We use signals in many cases, for example, to notify the game that a button has been pressed or that an animation has finished playing. This allows us to then tell the game what to do when certain events have occurred. Most nodes have built-in signals such as buttons and animation players, but we can also create our own custom signals. Does this make sense to you? If not, don't worry, we're going to look at it in diagram form. First, let's look at an example of built-in signals. So let's say we've added a button node to our main scene. Every time the button has been pressed, we want to check, has it been pressed? And then if it has been pressed, we want to notify the engine or the program to start the game. To do this, we connect the on button press signal to our node, which will then say, hey, if this button has been pressed, fire off the change scene code in our script, which will then start the game. So each time the on button press signal has been emitted, which is when we press the button, the game will start. Next up, let's look at an example of custom signals. Let's say in our script, we have a variable for our player health. If the player is hurt by, say, a monster or they drink a health potion, we need to update our health variable's value. To do this, we will create a custom signal to update this health value each time one of the events above occur. So each time we drink a health potion or we get hurt, then the signal will emit updating our health value. This will then cause either an increase or a decrease in our health value when these events emit our signal. So when our health signal emits because of either one of these events, our health variable will change. This might sound complex or maybe a bit messy. So let's do a practical example together. You will need no assets for this tutorial, but feel free to use any if you want. Once you've created and loaded your new Godot project, let's create a new scene with a node2d as the root node. Let's rename our node2d as main. Thereafter, save your main scene as main. With our main scene created and our node2d as our root, we can now start adding nodes to the scene. Now I want the scene to represent built-in signals. So what we're going to do is we're going to create a canvas layer with a button and a label. And if we press on the button, the label will be shown. So the label will initially be hidden. And when we press the button, the signal will emit and then the label will be made visible. So to do that, we will add a new child node of type canvas layer. This will hold all of our UI components. In the canvas layer, having the canvas layer selected, we'll add a child to the canvas layer. Let's add a button. With our button node added, let's center it. I'm going to make the text of the button press me. Selecting our canvas layer again, let's add a label as a child node. You want to ensure that this label node is a child node of the canvas layer and not the button or the main. I'm going to change the text of the label to be something like, hello there. Drag this label underneath the button. We do not want this label to be shown when we launch the game, so we need to change its visibility. You can either just click the eye icon next to it and that will hide it, or you can click on it and go into the properties panel and change its visibility boolean to false. Now, to actually make the signal work, we need to add a script to our root node. If you click on the button node and you head on over into its properties and click on node, you'll see the list of built-in signals available for this node. If you want to use a signal, say pressed or button up, all you need to do is double click it and connect it to the node that has a script where you want the event to fire off or emit the signal. For our unbutton press signal, we're going to connect it to our main script, which we had just created. Now we can say, hey, if this button has pressed when this scene is launched, what will it do? Well, we're going to take out this pass and drag in our label and say .visible equals true. So now when the button is pressed, the label should be made visible. If we press the button, the built-in signal will emit and the label will be made visible. Let's see if this works. And voila, that is your first taste of built-in signals. Now, let's try a custom signal. Let's do this in the same scene. For our custom signal, we want to have our health value, right? And each time a timer runs out, it will increase or decrease the health value. So to do that, we need to click on our main node and add two new timers. The first timer I'll call add health timer, and this will be called remove health timer. Now, in our code, let's just remove this piece for now, and then we'll start off by creating our custom signal. So to create a custom signal, we start off with the keyword signal, and then just the name of the signal. I'm going to call mine update health. Signals can also be defined with parameters, but for our case, we're not going to have any parameters. And if you would like to read more about custom signals and parameters in these signals, do refer to the documentation. There will be a link for it in the description box below. Now that we have our custom signal defined, we also need to define our health variable. I'm going to make it equal to 100. Then let's create two new functions. One function that will add health and one function that will remove our health. So this func add health has an amount parameter so that when we call it, we can just give the amount instead of having like a constant value. So each time this function is called, our health is gonna be equals to or added to our amount. Then if our health is less than 100, our health signal will then be emitted to update our health. So if our health isn't doing so well and we drink a potion, for example, our update health signal will be emitted with the new amount. To then emit the signal, we just say update health.emit with what we want to update, which is our health value. Let's just copy and paste this for our remove health function. For our remove health function, we want to decrease the amount, not add it. And if the health is more than zero, because if we aren't dead, then we'll emit the signal. Now the worlds between custom and built-in signals will collide because we will use the built-in timeout function of our timers to call these functions and then print the value. So on each of them, head into signals and select timeout, just double click it and connect it to the main script. And then we also need to go into inspector and enable auto start. So when the game starts, the timer will also start. Then in the add health timer timeout, we need to add our health. So we will just call our function with say the amount that we want to add. I'm just gonna say 10. Then we'll print this value to see if it's actually, you know, working. Then on the remove health timer timeout, we need to call the remove health function with how much we want to remove. Let's just say 20. Then we'll also print the health. So this is what your script should look like in the end. I just wanted to add that the timeout node of the timer will fire off every time this wait time has been finished. So this will fire off every second. Okay, let's run our scene to see if this works. We should see in the output panel that our health value is increasing or decreasing each time the timer times out. Okay, so this was a very basic and not really great example of how signals can benefit you and help you out in a game, because in an actual game project, it will be a lot more involved than this. And in my future tutorials, we will get to see it in a bit more action. But I do hope that this helped give you an idea of what a signal is and how it can be used. I do recommend that you go play around with it and experiment with both custom and built-in signals and read the documentation, because it'll really give you a better, like, in-depth understanding. Like, there's nothing better when you're trying to learn game development than actually just doing it. Okay, enough rambling on my part. I do hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you'd like. Until next time, bye!